temos hoje, agora para encerrar o nosso dia, o nosso primeiro palestrante internacional. Ele é da Itália, da região de Piemonte, no norte da Itália, da Agência de Proteção Ambiental da região do Piemonte. Meu amigo Pispico Rocco, ele tem mais de 20 anos de trabalho com GIS. A formação dele é em gestão de TI e vai ser o nosso primeiro palestrante internacional no dia de hoje.
Good afternoon. I'm Rocco. I'm Rocco Pispico, and I came from Italy, from the Piemonte region. Okay. Piemonte region is the green spot that you see. It's a little more or less than 25,000 kilometers. Our agency do more jobs, but the first one is prevent. Address and provide solution, information, and training also citizen and also private and technician. Our activities are prediction and prevention on anthropic and natural risk, measuring activity, monitoring many fields, and to do some reports. So you see how many fields we control, we manage. Me in particular, I work with geologists in natural risks. This is our experience. We start in the middle of 2009, and with a test phase. And when we understand that. Open source, GIS open source are the correct way for us. We convert every license fee to training more than 50 persons. So we collect many experience on weather, geology, and many more. The last one is the post-earthquake assessment that we'll talk about later. This is our server situation. We have three servers in replica, one the main in Torino, and Biella e Cuneo, based on Ubuntu server. Okay, table with data, geographical data, number of record. We don't have many users, but half of them are in multi-user editing. We choose database for a lot of pro. The first one is the multi-editing, because we are shared on the field and many other fields. The field with the less information and function is the raster management. This is our first experience. To manage landslide, we have to intersect, to interact many fields. So we put intelligence into the database, trigger and so on, jobs, and after the a digitalization on a landslide, automatically we provide a lot of statistics, landslide interaction with buildings or streets or permanent scatter fields and many other information. We manage sometimes complex symbology and also complex geometry. And so we choose QGIS because it's very easy to understand, to use. We came from Esri word, and QGIS is easy to introduce. Sometimes, as usual, it's not so stable, and spatial light is not so integrated, but we can live also. Another experience is based on a huge infrastructure project like high-speed train. Builders collect many data, many environmental data, and we have to manage this data. So 1,000 measurements came every day, every week, and we must to collect to share in for our colleagues and to do many analyses. Okay, we the database contains the measure, the descriptive method to collect data, the values, obviously. And so we manage, we control the schedule compliance for the builders. We avoid twice and more measurement, and we try to find some anomalies. These are the fields, water, air, noise, asbestos, and many others. Okay, now it's difficult to show another technology. I try to run Munin and SpagoB, and also I forgot to put Talend as an ETL software, very, very powerful. Okay, in our project, we try to save some money, to fix bugs, to create some function. Two of them are put on core of QGIS, the Python macros at the start, and also the style and the legend put in the database Postgres. We built some plugins for specific use, and we do an experience on ROAM Inframaps. Is QGIS based on portable device on Windows platform. So in 6 years, we manage less than 30,000 euros. And I think with the proprietary software, we can do anything. As you probably know, last month, the 24 August, there was an earthquake in the middle of Italy. During the middle of the June, we do a test to collect data in case of earthquake with only 3 municipalities. It's a test, it's okay. But 2 months later, the protection, the civil protection, the national civil protection asked us to manage on the field. We now manage 70 municipalities. We collect data from a QGIS mod, a QGIS project. We do a lot of data entry mask to collect data from people who never knows or never see QGIS. We do some report for the inspection team, and also for the administrative instances. All the data are collected by ARPA, to make some control, create the entire database. Data are shown, are disseminated with WMS, WFS services, and also with web page, web reports. So Ericus uses only open source software, QGIS, Qt, Godal, Ubuntu, Postgres, PHP, QGIS Server. This is some photo taken during the emergency. On the left, the computer room. So very, very hard. Luca is working on the computer room, on the chair. A midnight QGIS training party to train people, and customer care services. This guy, is the president of GFOS Italy. Okay, so the pros of our experience are Postgres, PostGIS, Goodall, multi-user editing, interaction with other GIS software, layout manager, most of all, form editor, and we can say that all of these are user-friendly. Cons, sometimes not so stable, and also raster function in Postgres is not so widespread. Okay, in the future, we will like to use RasDaemon to manage a lot of the raster image. We want to use Postgres to do many things like routing, address matching, gazetteer, and 3D analysis. And also leaflet and leads map to disseminate data. You can find any information from ARPA in these social things, website, on the website, on Twitter, and Geoportale also. Okay, we will grab.
Muito obrigado, Rocco. Nós tivemos a oportunidade de visitar a ARPA, que é o nome da instituição deles, e como ele apresentou aqui, a gente é muito grato porque a ARPA Piemonte pagou o desenvolvimento de uma funcionalidade no QGIS, que é o registro da simbologia de uma determinada camada diretamente no banco. Nós estamos utilizando isso hoje, algo que foi desenvolvido lá na Itália. Imaginem isso na lógica do software proprietário. Provavelmente eles teriam cobrado deles, teriam cobrado da gente e de quem mais precisasse desse tipo de funcionalidade. Então, percebam que o investimento que a ARPA Piemonte fez serviu para muita gente, assim como serviu para nós. Eles apresentaram aqui também o ROAM Intramaps. Já vejo diretamente um ponto de cooperação em que a gente pode estar aprendendo um com o outro. Nós temos a necessidade de ter uma ferramenta num dispositivo móvel para estar transportando nos helicópteros e ter informação ali na palma da mão e conseguir identificar o desmatamento, de que época que ele é, ter uma base de imagens. Então, o ROAM Intramaps é algo que a gente identifica como um ponto de cooperação. E, num dos últimos slides, eles colocaram que tem a intenção de trabalhar com Leaflet. Leaflet é uma plataforma livre para usar num WebGIS, e que nós estamos usando aqui já há alguns anos. Então, mais um ponto de cooperação que a gente identifica aí com a Itália.